Today, we are going to study muscular tissues. Now, muscular tissues, it means the tissues which derived from this mesoderm, and it consists of a special cells which having ability to contract and expand. It is a one type of cell which is responsible for contraction and relaxation. Now there are three types of muscular tissues are found in this body. First one is skeletal tissue or skeletal muscular tissue. Second one is smooth tissue, and third one is a cardiac tissue. Now, skeletal tissue, it is also called as striated type of this tissue, striated, because presence of striations. And second, the smooth type of tissues, they are non-striated. Means in the tissues, striations are absent. And cardiac type of tissue, that will be special type of tissue. It is a combination of these two types of this tissue. The structure is similar to this skeletal, but function is similar to the smooth muscles. Now these skeletal tissues, these tissues are voluntary, and these smooth tissues are involuntary. Cardiac tissues are also involuntary. Voluntary tissues means the tissues which control of our willpower, they are called as voluntary tissues. And involuntary tissues, the tissues does not control of our willpower. This is called as a involuntary tissues. Means voluntary tissues, skeletal muscles or striated tissues are the voluntary tissues, and smooth muscles and cardiac muscles are involuntary tissues. Now first, what is about the actually in detail? The striated or skeletal type of tissue. Means striations are present. This is about these tissues. Second, non-striated. Now striated tissue, striations are present. Now these striations means here tissue contain the actin and myosin filaments. Two types of proteins are present, and this actin and myosin filaments will be present in a particular region, that is a striations that will occur because of that proteins. And these striations, nucleus is present in an eccentric in position. and these ends are non-polar ends. These ends of these tissues are non-polar ends. Now then here, these smooth muscles, these polar ends are present, polar ends, and middle region that will give this swelling structure, and centrally placed nucleus. Nucleus is present in the center. Now then third, cardiac type of these muscles, the striations are present, but nucleus is present in a center, and all these tissues are interconnected to each other and to form the anastomosing branches. Now these striated type of these muscles, they are found in a skeleton. They are attached to the skeleton. Therefore, they are part of the skeletal tissues. And these muscles are present, smooth muscles are present in a viscera, smooth regions of this body. That is viscera, uterus. Therefore, it is called as a smooth. And cardiac type of muscles are found in heart. This is about this location. Then what is actually structure? Outer part that will be called as a sarcolemma. Sarcolemma. And inner part, the cytoplasm is found in inner region, that will be called as a sarcoplasm. And means these muscles are responsible for contraction and relaxation. How it gets contraction and relaxation? Now here, this one of the line is present. Now this line is called as a Z line. Z line. The distance between two Z lines, that part is called as sarcomere. And sarcomere is a structural and functional unit of muscle. Now this sarcomere, here two Z lines are there, they are connected to the strands or these proteins. These proteins are called as actin proteins. Means here two actin proteins are there in between two Z lines. Then in a center, here one of the additional protein is there. That protein is called as myosin protein. Myosin protein. Now this gap present between two actin proteins, this gap is called as H zone. This gap is called as a H zone. This is the actually structure of sarcomere. Now then, this actin protein, they are the isotropic, means to pass the light through their protein. Therefore, it is called as a I band. It is called as I band, isotropic. That means in between these two gel lines, two I bands are there. Because length of this actin filament, that is a I band, isotropic. And length of this myosin filament is called as A band. It is called as a A band. Anisotropic. Means not passed to this light. Therefore, it gives a dark nature. And this band, that will give a light nature. Means light and dark. These two types of bands, they are found in a single sarcomere. Now this, during this contraction, what happened? These two J lines come too close together. These two J lines come too close together. In that time, this zone, they are present in between two actin filaments, that will be disappear. This, during this contraction, H zone is disappear during contraction. And then at the time of this contraction, this actin filaments and myosin filaments, they are connected to each other and to formation of actomyosin complex. Actin plus myosin in presence of ATP, that is equal to the actomyosin complex plus ADP. This is about this actin plus myosin, that is a actomyosin complex. Here ATP play important role, and then one phosphate molecule is used to combination between these two regions. Now this process, that is a contraction, is takes place. Contraction, and calcium ions play important role in contraction of these muscles. Then during relaxation, what happen? These actomyosin complexes get reversed, and to give this actin plus myosin, this actomyosin complex, that will be get reversed or to convert the actin plus myosin. This process is called as a relaxation, and magnesium ions play an important role in relaxation. Means this is the opposite way. Means one way, straight way, and opposite, vice versa. This actin plus myosin is equal to actomyosin complex. Actomyosin complex get converted into actin plus myosin. This is about this contraction and relaxation process. Now this muscles play important role to this sarcomere, because it is the unit of muscle contraction. Now these skeletal muscles, they are connect means total in our body, how many muscles are there? That is a 639 muscles are present. Out of that 639 muscles, 634 muscles are present in the form of paired, and only 5 muscles are unpaired. Now these paired muscles means 317. These muscles are paired and they are antagonistic to each other. These paired muscles are antagonistic to each other. One muscle give contract and another muscles give relax. Example, in this upper arm, here two types of muscles are there. In front here, in front of this bone, that is a humerus, here presence of bicep type of muscle, and opposite here tricep muscles are there. And during this contraction of bicep muscles, automatic withdrawal of hand, and at the same time tricep muscles get relaxed, and then the reverse process, bicep muscles get relaxed, tricep muscles get contracts. This is about this antagonistic manner. These paired muscles are remains antagonistic in nature. Now then, these skeletal muscles, they are called as voluntary muscles, because they control of our willpower. And these muscles, they are concerned with which majority of this body, these muscles are present. And smooth muscles or smooth tissues, that is the non-striations are absent. They are involuntary. These muscles does not control of our willpower. These muscles are found in a mostly viscera of this body, means intestine, then uterus. Now these muscles are there. Now these muscles, they are actually, these muscles, they are involuntary, means contraction and relaxation. Now in skeletal muscles, contraction and relaxation is given very fast, but not longer period of time. They are easily fatigued, because what is under the fatigue? Fatigue means it is one of the stage, does not respond to stimulus. Means no contraction, no relaxation that we occur in a fatigue. Means these muscles are easily fatigued, but smooth muscles, their contraction and relaxation is very slowly, and they are not easily fatigued, because this is a slowly process that will take place. Then third type of this muscle, that is a cardiac type of muscle. Now this cardiac muscle, they are found only in a heart. They are also involuntary, but there is a mixing of these two muscles. Means structure is similar to the skeletal, but functional is similar to the smooth. But here nucleus is present in the center. Nucleus is present in the center, and the striations are present. But these muscles are interconnected to each other, and to formation of T-like shape. There is a tri-like. Means this one of this muscle is there, but another muscle will be attached to middle of this other muscle. That is about the T-triad type of these muscles, and these muscles are interconnected to each other. But these cardiac muscles, not fatigued, easily fatigued. They are means their contraction and retraction is like as a smooth type, but not fatigue. At the time of fatigue, then stop this life. Now this is about this actually these types of muscles, but here these are actin and myosin filaments. These filaments are important for this one of the theory, that is Huxley, H.E. Huxley is the name of scientist. He discovered this theory. This theory is related to the sliding filamentous theory, and they are related to this contraction and relaxation. Then outer side, that is a perimyosin part is there, inner side presence of the endomyosin part. This is about these two parts. Then both ends of these muscles, tendons are present. Muscles block supplied with the blood vessels. They are myelinated. Motor nerve fibers are there, because these muscles are contracted. They are connected to the motor nerve. Now then, cardiac muscles. That is the heart is formed by cardiac muscles. That is myocardium. Then each fiber, that is sarcolemma, is there. Nucleus is present in the center. These other structures are there. Sarcoplasm, perinuclear region, and pre of myofibril, it contains some organelles. More organelles are present, that is endoplasm, reticulum, fat, glycogen droplets, and more mitochondria are present. More Golgi complex is there. Sarcoplasm, intercalated disc are present in our cardiac muscles. The network of reticular fibers or collagenous fibers, coronary artery, replace supplies to the cardiac muscle, that is a sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves will be innervated to these muscles. Therefore, they are antagonistic in function. Now, this is about the muscular tissues. Thank you very much.